I will be stronger. They'll call me freedom, just like a waving flag.
When I get older, I will be stronger. They'll call me freedom, just like a waving flag. And then it goes back, and then it goes back, and then it goes back.
Oh. I don't know where Dorothy is. Dorothy, what's your new favorite country?
South Africa.
You love South Africa?
Mm-hmm.
Why do you love it so much?
Because it has all the animals.
All the animals. It's got zebras and...
giraffes.
And rhinos and...
hippos.
And lions and...
crocodiles.
And cheetahs and...
meerkats.
And bush babies and...
wolf dogs.
That's my favorite one.
Phinda, the beastie
baba. I'm gonna be the tiger. You be...
impala.
Okay, you're the impala. I'm the tiger. Okay, you're the impala. Go. You're the leopard. Okay. Mm-hmm. I'm the impala. Guys.
Good morning.
Guys. Jessica says this has been maybe her favorite week ever.
I think this has been my favorite week ever.
This place is wild.
Africa. We are at the andBeyond Phinda Reserve, staying at the Mountain Lodge.
Two babies. Get closer to the babies.
Shh. You gotta be nice and respectful. Look, there's the mommy and the Dorothy and the Manila. And the Dorothy and the Manila are playing. Look at them playing.
Aww.
Along our travels, I've been making kind of like a behind the scene list in my journal of some of the absolute favorite just moments. Not like favorite countries, but favorite moments throughout our travels that were just very, very special to me. And sometimes they're not on camera, but this was one of them. When we arrived to the Phinda Lodge, and we arrived kind of late because our flight had been delayed, and the sun was like just about to go down, and they're like, hey, you kind of missed the time for a safari drive, but do you want to go out for a short one real quick, and you can bring your kids? Of course we said yes. And we went out, and the sun was like going down, it was a little bit chilly, but it was like just the four of us on the car, and it was quiet, and the animals were beautiful. That was my favorite.
Yeah, and Dorothy was so cute. Right when we pulled out, we saw this beautiful giraffe in the road, and Dorothy goes, oh, you were just right here waiting for us.
That's so funny. I hope I caught that on camera.
You were just waiting for us.
Yes, exactly.
You were just waiting for us.
Oh, there's another one.
There is another one. Where do you think they're going? To the grocery store?
Yeah.
Hey, buddy.
I know.
Where'd he go?
Should we go see if we can find some zebra and wildebeest?
Yeah.
Yeah, you see a daddy and what else? Which ones are there?
On the sister. Oh, that's the sister.
That's a Dorothy.
No.
There's a daddy and a mommy and a Dorothy. And Amia.
And the mommy and the daddy.
Yeah.
And the baby. And me.
But that was just such a special moment. We've been very, very grateful for the opportunity to be here on the safari. This is when you're like one with nature, one with God, and very, very grateful for everything you're experiencing.
This place is incredible. We want to introduce you really quickly to our guide, Taylor, and to our spotter, Busani. Busani can find anything.
Also, his name is Eagle Eyes.
We just call him Eagle Eyes.
We'll have binoculars, and he was like telling us where to look, and we still can't see it. And yet he, with his naked eye, while our Jeep is driving, can spot anything. He's incredible.
And you can tell the difference between a black and a white rhino and between any sort of like deer from so far away.
And old dung and new dung and old footsteps and new footsteps. He's incredible at tracking.
And Taylor, she knows everything.
She was our guide and she was just so much fun. I kind of feel like you just want to hang out with her anyways.
I told her I'm going to bring her to Utah and Colorado sometime and show her the mountain lions and the deer and the little bunnies in my yard.
Wait, shout out to Phinda Reserve. Because they are just full of surprises. They surprised us with lunch by the pool. They surprised us with those snacks on the mountainside.
Yeah.
We come up over the mountain and all of a sudden there's these like lanterns and all these drinks and stuff set
this
up.
This like romantic little at safari
first I was
getaway.
Like, oh guys, I don't think we were supposed to be here. But the surprise was for us.
And beyond, it sounds cheesy, but they go above and beyond. And really like,
oh my gosh, is that why it's their name?
I don't know. But they really go above and beyond and treat you so well.
It's been one of those brands where we had such an amazing experience here where I'm like, where else can we find that andBeyond experience?
So one of the days in between our drives, we went out into the community. It was really, really special.
If there is something we need, it's a leap of faith, a step away from the comfort zone and be a little brave. So take a look around you. How far can you see? How far do you think you can run? Standing on your knees. It's a beautiful world out there. Just don't pass on the dare. If you have the will and a moment to spare, it's a beautiful world out there. It's a beautiful world out there. It's a beautiful world out there. Just don't pass on the dare. If you have the will and a moment to spare, it's a beautiful world out there. It's a beautiful world out there. Oh, if you have the will and a moment to spare, it's a beautiful world out there. It's a beautiful world out there.
So we made a donation of our own to these schools and also for Pin Pals. The pin that I designed for this location, 100% of those profits will go to these schools. Here's the link. You can sign up, become a pin pal. Each month you will receive a pin and a letter from Dorothy Manila, and 100% of those profits go back to charity and nonprofit services at those locations.
If you don't want to subscribe and just want to buy this Phinda Reserve pin, then you can do that as well.
Yeah. If someone hit you up and was like, hey, I want to do an African safari, where should I go or how should I do it? What do you think?
Well, for sure, check out andBeyond Travel. They have a bunch of different places all over Africa. And I would highly recommend spending at least 3 days in one place and then 3 days maybe in a different country or in a different place just to get some variations in terrain and animals. And that's the way to do it.
Yeah, but that's a good amount. If you can do like 5 to 6 days. Some people think that's too much. We were told that you should only do like 2 to 3 days, but we could do this forever. But we really love wildlife. More than 3 days, that kind of takes the stress off. Because say you only do 2 days, then you're going to be stressed like, I really hope we see everything. But that's not how wildlife works. It's unpredictable. You can't plan it. So 3 to 5 days, as much as possible, it's amazing. We saw everything. But you can't, like, wildlife, you can't predict it, you can't control it. And we've done a lot of wildlife photography in our travels so far, so we've kind of learned how it works. And we're gonna let you in on a very big secret. The secret is how to see everything. And the secret is gratitude. Because if you are grateful for everything you see, then you will see everything. That's how it works.
Hey!
I've been trying to do it right. I've been living a lonely life. I've been sleeping here instead. I've been sleeping in my bed. Sleeping in my bed. Such shall be family. All the blood that I will bleed. I don't know where I belong. I don't know where I went wrong. But I can write a song. Belong with me, you're my sweet heart. I belong with you. You belong with me, you're my sweet heart. Hey. I don't think you're right for him. Hey. Look at what might have been if you took a bus to Chinatown. Hey. I'd be standing on canal and Bowery. She'd be standing next to me. I belong with you. You belong with me. You're my sweet heart. I belong with you. You belong with me. You're my sweet.
Thank you, andBeyond. Phinda Reserve is incredible. And everyone here at the Mountain Lodge was just wonderful.
Thank you, guys. We'll see you next week.
What you looking at there, buddy?
No, I woke up.
What did you see up there?
Daydreaming?